I'll run you over.
I was in the van when he hit you.
All I did was cash in Seamus's betting slip after he'd been shot.
Pregnant? Is it Tony's?
I want you to come away when you tell me.
You are?
I'll have her. It's what she wants.
You want to start praying for a miracle? Even out or you find a bit of buried treasure.
I think you find that's mine.
Hey, take the weight off your trotters and I'll make us all a nice brew.
Where's our Jackie?
I lost the whole cargo because of you. Now it's payback time. If we tell Mum that we've got 50 grand, she's going to want to know where we got it from.
Keep your voice down, they're only upstairs.
And it still won't be enough to help our Mercy. We'll never get another 15, 24 hours. No way.
So what now? And where's our Jackie? We need her here in case they ring.
I think she might be in trouble.
Really, really wasn't our fault. We thought it was just a van full of vodka.
None of your business what it was.
Those people in there, they were hurt. They needed help.
Let me tell you then.
Listen to me. I'm so desperate. My sister needs the cash, please.
It's all been so simple. But now I'm going to have to kill you.
So how'd it go with Tony?
I didn't tell him.
What?
Couldn't. He's moving away with Jackie McQueen. And they're dead happy, so.
Do you know what? I made up for them. And what about you, eh?
He was stood there telling me how much he loves her. I couldn't do it. I just couldn't.
Do you know what? If he loved her, then he shouldn't go round knocking other women up, should he?
Do you mind?
Mummy's bang out of order. Well, you should call the CSA on him.
If he's not going to be around to be a dad, yeah, well, I'd sooner just not bother telling him. Embarrassing enough, everyone round here.
Look, who cares what people think?
Look, I feel way too sick to have an argument, okay? I don't want him to know, and that's the end of it. We'll manage.
Yeah? How?
And if Tony doesn't know, then no one else can either. Have you got that? So you don't go blabbing.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Is he you?
I don't know.
I thought you didn't care. You didn't answer my call.
Yeah, but I came looking for you. I'm gonna come with you. I love you, Jackie. I always have.
I love you too.
Come quickly.
Yeah, come this way.
Jackie!
This is the main reason why we're here. This woman can save Mercedes' life. I'll fill this bag. So it's good.
Come on, let's go.
Go.
That's for all the poor people in the van.
What?
Hey, I made you some lunch.
Lunch? Mm. Not now, I couldn't possibly.
Well, it is lunchtime. Now's as good a time as any.
I meant, not now that I know the truth. I honestly think I would choke.
Whatever, fine.
I feel like I can smell him everywhere.
Who?
Seamus Brady.
You can smell him?
Oh, don't worry about her. There you go.
Thanks. Well, it's his home now, isn't it? Not ours.
You stop being so ridiculous. This place is as much ours now as it always has been.
Paid for with the blood money from a stolen betting slip.
Look, Seamus is dead, okay? And if he wasn't, he'd have bought a dog and we'd be out on the streets by now.
And you're okay with that?
Yes, I am actually.
Baby, I'm fine, okay? Tony's with me. Calm down, okay? Yeah, the police have got Trudy, but they haven't got Trevor. We need to talk about that, do you? Okay. Yeah, I'll speak to you in a bit, love.
Okay.
Listen, I'm just going to throw some stuff in the back. How long we got?
Oh, well, a flight leads to Alicante in a couple of hours. We're going to have to hurry up, though, because it won't take Trevor long to find out where I live.
Oh, my passport's still in date.
Can't believe you're coming with me. You and me in our own sunny paradise, eh?
Well, there's nothing here. Not without you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, listen. I've got to get some money to Dr. Brown, so hurry up, okay?
Yeah, go on. Go on.
Jackie.
Good news. I've got the money.
Hey, you all right?
Yeah, fine. Just getting off in something nicer as tea, you know, instead of all the hospital slop. You planning your getaway then?
Yeah, listen, about that. I was probably a little bit excited earlier when I blabbed. Jackie wants to keep things quiet, all right?
All right, yeah, okay. You're not the only one keeping things quiet around here. Sinead.
Everything okay?
Well, it's a bit late to ask that now, isn't it? Now you're jetting off a lady muck. Right, come on, we've got to go. No, Mum, right, he needs to know. You're making a big mistake here.
Need to know what?
Nothing. It's fine, just ignore it. No, listen, you tell him or I'm going to. No.
Tell me what?
Mum's pregnant.
Hey?
It's yours. You're going to be a daddy, Tony.
A message from Nancy. She wants Oscar upstairs with her.
Well, she can't come downstairs and tell me herself.
All right, don't shoot the messenger.
Sienna. Look, whatever happens, yeah, whatever she asks you, you can't admit that you knew about me cashing in Seamus's bank, okay?
Yeah, I'm trying to stay out of it, so.
Sorry.
It's all right, don't sweat it, she'll get over it.
She'll have to. Otherwise, we'll be keeping in the car park tonight.
Do you want me to take him upstairs?
No. Tell Nancy that Oscar would rather chill out with his dad. Wouldn't you? Eh?
Will you?
You didn't say a word when I saw you before.
I was going to, but then you said you were moving away, so.
Well, you don't think I still had the right to know?
What do you think he's want to know? I mean, what's the point? You and Jackie are really happy and you're not even going to be here.
It was still my baby, though, isn't it? I can't believe I'm going to be a dad again. I mean, I thought all that was well behind me.
Well, if you didn't want to be a daddy, Tony, you should have been more careful.
I didn't even think that there was the slightest chance. You know what I went through.
Well, you should have used something anyway. I mean, if you two heard of STIs? That's what you're always telling us, lot.
Are you sure that it's mine?
Yes, of course she is. I mean, what are you trying to say?
Sorry, like, I didn't mean it like that. It's just a bit of a shock. I mean, today of all days.
Tony, I'm really sorry. You shouldn't have to hear it like that.
Yeah, well, he had to find out somehow. And you're about to disappear without forking out for so much as a dummy.
Diana, I don't know what to say.
You don't have to say anything. It's my problem. I'll deal with it.
You haven't said anything, have you? What's happened? Have you seen Trudy?
I've got the gun here. That's all here.
What? How?
It doesn't matter how. What's important is Mercy's going to be all right. But Trevor's still out there. Which means I'm going to have to go away.
For how long? You're not coming back, are you?
Listen to me, Phoebe.
You could be all right. You thought you were a lad. But the family, they're not safe with me around, love.
You can't leave. This is fair. You shouldn't have to go.
Phoebe, I'm going away with Tony. I can have a fresh start. I've got somewhere nice in mind. Somewhere where me and Merce used to love.
What's Myra going to do without you? We need you.
I need you, Jackie.
No.
Listen to me. You don't need me. You don't. This last year, I've watched you grow. Do you know what?
I'm so proud of you, Phoebe. You're the best thing that ever happened to me. The only thing I ever got right. Don't leave me, Jackie. Please. Look, if I could take you with me, you, Tony, I'd be the happiest woman alive, but I can't. I'm so sorry, babe. I can't take you with me. Because your life's here. With my mum. She sees you as one of her own now. And you are the daughter that I never could have. And that is why I am trusting you to look after that bunch of idiots in there. I just hope that you can forgive me. And understand one day. When I go, I just want you to tell everybody that I love them. And no matter how many times I've mouthed off, I'm sorry. I'll never forget what you did. When no one else wanted me. You said, back here, Phoebe. You know I'm not good at this sort of stuff, love. Come on. Just go in there. And see them one last time. Say it behind your head if you can't say it out loud.
Oh, he said he's making a cup of tea.
Hooray for him. Maybe he'd like to do a front page spread on that instead.
No, I think he thought you might like one.
Thought I'd made my feelings on that perfectly clear. That kitchen and everything else in this place is stolen from a dead man's pocket. A bit off-putting, I find. Anything else?
Actually, there was one more thing. I thought you said you were going to stop taking those things.
What do you mean?
The painkillers. It's pretty obvious.
Well, it's clear whose side you're on, then.
It can't have been an easy decision to make, and I'm sure he made it with you in mind. The only other option was to sell your sister's old flat.
Well, seeing as everyone thinks that I'm so awful for wanting to hang on to my sister's memories, then I won't. I'll just get rid of it like he wanted me to all along. So why don't you go down there and tell Darren to ring the estate agents, and then I'm going to pay Cheryl back every penny he stole from her father.
Maybe you ought to tell him yourself. I mean, he is your husband. You know, for better or worse. And the only side that I'm on here is the children's. For what it's worth, I'd have done exactly what he did to keep a roof over their heads.
Hey, we're gonna get a chippy tea and then we'll get our heads together. I'm running out of ideas here, love.
Mum. Gonna be fine.
Right. Teresa wants fish cakes. Mum wants
jam.
And our John Paul wants a large battered sausage.
In your dreams, love.
Yeah. Where is it?
I'm gonna leave in a minute. The bag's by the door. You've got everything you need, so don't miss it.
Phoebe said you'd been to see Trudy. I mean, are you going soft in the air?
Yeah, I want to make sure the police got to her first before Trevor did.
It's now Mercy we're bothered about, not her.
Yeah, what are we going to do?
I don't know. You know Mercy. She's got 9 lives. I've got a good feeling she's going to be fine.
Well, I don't know. Did my tea leaves this morning and all I got was bleeding hearts ripped apart.
I know. Why don't you contact our tea and see if she knows where Mercy is?
What? I thought you'd do that.
Calm, can you hurry up, please? I'm starving. I can eat a dog with mange.
Probably what you will eat, love. Fat Ethel found half a rat's head in her steak and kidney pie last time she were there.
Well, where was the other half, then?
Exactly.
Eh? Maybe we could say we found one too, and then we can put the compo towards the ransom.
That is ridiculous. Where exactly are we going to get a rat's head from?
Steve's kid's got a gerbil. Is that any good?
Yeah, that's brilliant, that. Yeah, what we'll do is we'll break in, grab the gerbil, rip its head off and pop it in Nana's prawn bowl. Idiot. Look after him for me.
Oh, taking Mickey in it.
She weren't a bad idea.
I'm gonna get off.
I'm going to sort this for you.
All right, love.
I love you, Mum.
Crikey, Jack, I know things are bad. I love you too. Go on, then.
Hey, Jack. What you said yesterday, I mean, you wouldn't really go and leave us, would you?
Well, that's rich coming from the prodigal son.
But, I mean, things are going really well for you now, and you've got Tony back in your life.
Yeah, you're right. I'm going to keep tight hold of him this time.
Yeah, you do that. Remember what I said yesterday as well. There's no us without you.
And you ask me what I want this year, and I try to make this kind and clear. Just a chance that maybe we'll find better days. 'Cause I don't need boxes wrapped in strings and designer love and empty things. Just a chance that maybe we'll find better days. So take
listen, you don't have to sell Becca's flat, okay?
No, I want to. But for now, I'm treating you guys first. That's what I should have done all along.
Mm-hmm. You that little man.
I did his first.
If we all just stopped and said a prayer for them. So
a few hours to check in. Did you call a cab? Tony, I'm going to do this quick before I change my mind. Just seeing Phoebe's face, it was awful, but I know she's better off. I'm sure.
I just had some news.
Well, it better be good. Tony.
I don't even know how to say it.
That's a bit out, love.
Diane's pregnant. It's mine. I had no idea.
And she's having a baby.
I mean, we only went on that one date.
That's a result, isn't it?
Jackie, don't, please.
You're gonna be a daddy again.
Yeah, well, why now? Hey, why with someone else?
It was never gonna be with me, though, was it?
Hey, it doesn't change anything. Hey? It's just a shock, that's all.
Changes everything, Tony.
What do you mean?
Oh. It was just going to be so perfect. Oh, Tony, you can't leave with me now. You need it here.
That baby needs a daddy. And if you leave it like this, you'll never forgive yourself, Ollie.
Yeah, but I don't want to stay here. Not without you. I mean, what about our plans, eh? Our sunny little paradise.
Oh, we should have guessed, shouldn't we? I was never going to get the happy ending of my own.
Jackie, I know you're trying to do the right thing, but this time you have to think of yourself. We are meant to be together. I love you. I want you to be my wife. See? I was going to ask you last night, but you didn't show up. Don't break my heart again, Jackie. Because losing you was the worst thing that ever happened to me.
Tell me about it.
We've only got one life. Please. So you stay with me for the rest of mine. Talk to Diane. We'll work something out.
No. No. You're not the kind of bloke who walks away from his own child. If you did, you wouldn't be my Tony.
Please, Jackie. Please don't leave me.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Please don't go, Jackie. I love you.
I love you too. But sometimes... love isn't enough, Tony. Please don't say love. I just really hope, please, love. Say it doesn't mean my heart won't stick away. Look at me like that. There's no need to worry, man. You see, just where we're at. Just please don't say you love me, cause I might not say.
Wednesday's 7:30 on E4 at Youngers. Or is it Youngers? Tomatoes, tomatoes. Catch up on 4OD. 9 o'clock tonight on Channel 4. The Cats are still in charge of Countdown. Nick Hewer, your job is safe. Well, next up tonight, the latest on Boston. Channel 4 News.
Say it back.